Again, we need to find an integral that represents the area between two curves, except this time, as it turns out, we're going to have to split that integral up into two pieces. Let's take a look at a graph and see why. Our graph of cosine of x oscillates between 1 and negative 1. Cosine of x has zeros at pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. It has maximum values at 0 and 2 pi, and a minimum value at x equals pi, at least for this first cycle here. Our other function is just a horizontal line y equals 1 half. And of course, keep in mind that we're only interested in the interval 0 to 3 pi over 2. So the area that we're looking for in this case is this area here plus this area down here. And maybe you can see now why we have to split this up into two integrals to find the area. For these x values over here, cosine is the upper of the two functions, whereas for these x values through here, cosine is the lower of the two functions. So we need to split up our integral into two pieces, one where cosine is the upper function and 1/2 is the lower function, and the other integral where 1/2 is the upper function and cosine is the lower function. The limits of integration on this first integral will just be the x values for this first region. Likewise, the limits on the second integral will be the x values for this region. To determine those limits, again, we're just going to have to take the two functions and set them equal to each other. So you have to know something about your unit circle. You have to know that the cosine function equals 1/2 at pi over 3 and 4 pi over 3. But fortunately, 4 pi over 3 is outside of the region that we're interested in, so we're really only interested in this pi over 3. Pi over 3 is going to be the x value right in here. So our limits of integration are the x values for this region, which go from 0 up to pi over 3. And our limits of integration for this integral are the x values in this region, which go from pi over 3 all the way up to 3 pi over 2. This integral is what we were looking for. Of course, we should probably evaluate it. That's going to take a little bit of work, but let's just run through it really fast. Integral of cosine is sine. Integral of 1/2 is 1/2 x. The same is true on the second integral, and we can use our fundamental theorem to get the answer. Plugging in our upper limit of integration, then subtracting and plugging in our lower limit of integration on both of these integrals and trying to keep our pluses and minuses straight gives us all of this result, which we can simplify using our unit circle. Okay, if I haven't messed anything up, you'll notice that we have a couple of square root of 3 over 2s, which add to give us two of those, and the twos cancel, and those two terms then combine to just give us a square root of 3. The same thing happens with this pi over 6 term. We have two of them, they're both negative, they're going to combine to give us a pi over 3. We also have this positive 3 pi over 4, and we have a plus 1. If we wanted to simplify as much as we possibly can, we can combine these two fractions that both have a pi on them. That's going to give us a square root of 3 plus a 1 plus another 5 pi over 12, and that should be the answer. That should give us the area between those two curves on the interval that was given to us.